This is KCRA 3 News at 6:30.
Wildfires are, of course, dangerous for many reasons while they're burning, but some risks can linger for months or even years after the flames are extinguished.
KCRA 3's meteorologist Heather Waldman spoke with a scientist working to improve our understanding of debris flows.
A debris flow is a type of landslide that can occur when heavy rain falls over or near a recent burn scar. This video from the USGS is after the 2016 Fish Fire in Los Angeles County. 7 months later, a storm triggered this. A debris flow can very quickly develop and travel over 35 miles per hour, sweeping away anything in its path. And the science dedicated to understanding this phenomenon is relatively new, so there's a lot to learn. I spoke to Dr. Daniel Horton, who researches debris flows at Northwestern University in Illinois. Horton is developing a model that can help forecast the likelihood of a debris flow for a specific area. He says there are a lot of factors to consider.
There's a number of factors that go into determining whether a debris flow will happen. Some of it has to do with the shape of the catchment or the river basin. Some of it has to do with the vegetation and the severity of the burn that has occurred there.
And then, of course, how much precipitation is forecast to fall over an area and how long the precipitation will last. Horton is basing his model on a real-life event from last year near Big Sur, when heavy rain washed over the Dolan fire burn scar and created a debris flow that knocked out a section of Highway 1. The model attempts to simulate weather conditions to determine if specific areas are at highest risk. Horton says this could be life-saving information as the risk for large wildfires in California increases.
There's a number of things coming together that indicate that climate change is really going to drive an increase in risk of wildfires and ultimately debris flows. And so there's a need to develop tools like the tool that we're developing.
Horton's model is still several steps away from being used in day-to-day forecasting, but he and his team are confident in its accuracy so far. The goal is to eventually predict the probability of a debris flow up to 7 to 10 days out, giving plenty of warning time for people to stay out of harm's way. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.